This video is entitled Being on the Autism Spectrum and Relating to Non-Autistic Friends. That simply means being Aspie and relating to friends that are neurotypical. Now, how do I actually find this and how do I deal with it, being a person on the autism spectrum? I have very few friends that are non-autistic. I have some friends that are younger than me. One of them works in pathology, another one is a chaplain in the army, and there are other friends I have, but I don't really have much contact with them. But one of the difficulties that I find in relating to neurotypical friends is that often when I try and explain to them the ways I think and feel, that they often become a little bit critical of the way I might perceive information or react to something it is that they say. And it can be very difficult because I think in their minds they think that I look like them, but yet I don't think the same way as they do. And this does create challenges and difficulties. And of course, when you work in an environment that's neurotypical, the problems are difficult as well, because again, you're dealing with someone, I'm dealing with other people that aren't cognitively wired the same way as I am, and I find that very, very difficult. Now, it's very hard to actually present the autism spectrum to someone to say, well, I have Asperger's syndrome, or when actually should you or should I disclose that I have Asperger's syndrome? Well, I think the thing is that as you get older, and I was diagnosed at 25 and I'm actually turning 40 this year, it's very hard to be able to explain what Asperger's syndrome is. But what I do is Asperger Services Australia kindly created for me a business card. And this business card, of course, is, you know, formed into cards from this single A4 piece of paper. Wherever I go, I take that with me, and if I meet someone or someone's helpful or someone's talkative, I give them a card and they can look at it and they can say, okay, this is the name of the person and this is what they're about. They advocate for Asperger's syndrome. So that's a way of promoting a bit more awareness. When I've been overseas, I've also taken the card with me and given it out to people, so that it does help to raise the awareness. But I think that the difficult thing is that for adults with Asperger's syndrome, that often we can be wrongly told that we put ourselves down, or we actually highlight too many of our faults, or we're too self-conscious, or we should be more self-conscious about what people think of us. Frankly, all that goes out the door with me. I'm not interested in what people think, and I have no time to sort of worry about what people think of me or whether I put myself down or not. Simply, I'm explaining my strengths and weaknesses, and if people don't understand that, then they have to just tolerate it. And I think awareness of Asperger's syndrome has increased a lot over the last 5 years. I think there's more awareness of it now. People are aware of it, but they don't know how to relate to it. In another 5 years of evolution, I think that people will start to understand it, because the increase of diagnosis is going to make society more aware of Asperger's syndrome as a condition. I regard myself as Aspie because Asperger's syndrome defines who I am as a person. And I get tired of people that say to me that I don't have it, or that I should, you know, distance myself from it, because it's like a lifeline. It's something that I've had to learn to deal with. And people still don't always understand. I still get rejection now, and I still find people don't always understand the ways I think and feel. And it can make things very, very difficult, as I've written in my blog post that's on my blog, my account as an Aspie, being the odd jigsaw piece. People don't understand. And I find as an adult that adults that are not on the autism spectrum in my peer group just still really don't, they don't really understand it fully. They still try to see me as being like them, but I don't think the same way as them. I don't process information the same way as them. It's not that I'm doing it intentionally, it's just the way that I think and I communicate. I find it sometimes that there's connections in my brain that don't always connect. And this involves emotions and other thought processes. The thought processes don't always gel or merge together. And as I get older, I find myself wondering, well, who am I as a person? What have I achieved in my life? And exactly what is my purpose in life? And I find that advocacy of the autism spectrum is what something I need to do. And with the election here in Queensland, I hope that a change of government or a government that gets in and understands Asperger's syndrome and provides funding for software testing such for specialist Stern or autism works becomes a reality, because we need to get adults on the autism spectrum into employment. They cannot exist on welfare. They cannot be isolated from the community. They're people that have ability, and they have demonstrated their ability outside these diagnostic criteria. Personally, I think the DSM-5 and the changes to that are absolutely insulting to persons on the autism spectrum, because people with Asperger's syndrome are going to lose that label, and that's not going to help us. And I think that a bunch of psychiatrists in the United States ought to sod off out of the reclassification of it and leave it alone, because people need that Asperger's syndrome to be able to get the support that they need. And believe me, it is essential when you try and survive in this world. I'd like to conclude in this video by saying that with the post that connecting with it, Neurotypicals is challenging, but it's a matter of informing, educating and enlightening them. And this is something that with more awareness and education is possible. So in conclusion, I hope you have got something out of this video. And once again, if you have any comments or queries, please feel free to comment on this video, and I'll respond to it as best I can. Thank you very much for listening.